got you there, didn't I? It's a neat little trick I learned back in the day. Hello everyone. My name is... Actually, that doesn't matter. What does matter is the story that I am here to tell you. This story is about a baker. This baker was an honest man. Maybe too honest. All he wanted to do was bake bread, sell bread, and make bread. Get it? Hello, sir. Would you like to buy a bread roll? They're only 50 pence. I need it to feed my family, sir. Oh, thank you, thank you. Thank you, my children will eat good tonight. How about you, madam? Madam, excuse me. Madam, please don't ignore me, madam! You want to ignore me? Ignore this! Oh. Hi, sir. Would you like to buy a bread roll? You get the idea. Now, some time passed and business was booming. The baker had made enough money to set up his own bakery, and all was going well. But all it took was one customer. One devil's spawn that came in the form of a wrinkly old bag of wrinkles. Hello, sir. Could I interest you in a bread roll? Sir? But the old man said no. No! I've known many men like you in my day, and if one thing's for certain, it's that you're all greedy little scum. The baker was shocked. How dare you, sir? The argument continued, and it got bigger and bigger and all over a piece of bread. And I bet your mother's a whore as well! How dare you, little boy? Do you know who I am? The baker had no clue. No, I do not. I have no clue who you are. So the old man told him. I, sir, am the Wizard of Volvic. He was the Wizard of Volvic. And I put a curse on you and your damn bakery as well. Now, obviously, there was no such thing as the Wizard of Volvic, but our poor little baker didn't know that. Hey, Johnny, Cynthia, hear this. He's saying he's the Wizard of Volvic. Have you ever heard of the Wizard of Volvic before? No, of course not. Where'd he go? The old man had vanished. Little did the baker know, his taxi just arrived to take him home. But then things started to go horribly wrong. A week later, the baker had forgotten to pay his bills. Oh no. Oh no, oh no, oh no, I forgot to pay my bills. They're gonna close down my bakery. They're gonna take my shop. What am I gonna do? It's that old man. It's that curse that old man put on me. He's the reason why I didn't pay my bills. You know what I need to do? I need to find him. I need to find him and get that curse lifted. So off he went. He started his journey, which took him far, far away. And little did he know, the old man had died. But when he did find out, he was devastated. Wait, so you're telling me that the old man who put a curse on me is now dead? Okay, yeah. It's fine. I can handle that, yeah. I'll be fine. But he most definitely was not fine. But there was nothing he could do. The only thing he could do was start his long journey back home. But on this journey home, he came across a crooked young man who claimed that he could cure anything, be it diseases, lift curses. And the baker believed him. It was clearly a scam, but he was desperate. Please help me, I'm so desperate. I just need somebody to lift this damn curse on me. You see, this old man, he put a curse on me, and then I didn't pay my bills, and My wife left me, and everything's just going bad. At this point, the young man just wanted him to stop. He made a business out of fooling people like the baker, but what he would do is kill them so that he could keep their money. And then I left the shop door open and all the bread went moldy, and it was just a bad, bad week. Listen. Just calm down, mate, all right? Calm down. I think I've got the perfect cure for your curse. Yeah? Now that you say it, I do believe we have a cure for people.
Bakers,
specifically, who have been cursed by old men.
Yeah.
And all you have to do is bury yourself alive. Now, I know, it sounds a bit drastic, but trust me, we have got perfect success rates from this treatment. Honestly, zero complaints. All right, but remember, this is all down to you.
Well, I mean,
sure,
why not?
I've got nothing else to lose. The baker was doomed, and he didn't even know it. Right, sir. So, just step through these doors here, and my colleagues will be with you shortly. Just through here.
Right, okay.
Oh, hey guys, are you the ones who are gonna, okay, cool. Just quick question. I'm not gonna die, am I? You will take me out, right? Before I... Right, okay, well, I'll just pop to the loo. We'll quit. Whoa! Hey, no. So please don't run away! Turns out I was dead this whole time. Technically, I've been a ghost. But in all seriousness, the poor baker had no clue what happened, and he ended up dying. But the point of my story is that we can all be bakers. But the only thing separating us from being bakers and real bread makers is ourselves. So think about that the next time somebody tries to put a curse on you. Do what I should have done. You take that curse and you shove it right up there.